Hey guys, welcome back. This is Bernard from the BTNHD, and today is all about my top six registry hacks that I like to use within Windows 10, and I'm going to show you guys what I do when I get a new machine. So let's get started. All right, so there's a couple of registry hacks that I like to do when I get a new machine, and that machine has Windows 10, right? And the first one I like to do is add an app to the desktop context menu. So how would you do this? So before we even start, I'm going to right-click on the start menu, go to run, type in WinVer, hit OK, and I'm running everything within a Windows 10 version 1909. Now on the desktop, we are going to right-click on the start menu, go to run, and within here, we are going to type in regedit, and we are going to hit OK. We're going to get the user account control. We are going to hit yes for that. From here, we are going to select the HKEY classes root. And the reason why I'm selecting it is because with Windows 10 and the registry editor, you are able to type in the location. So this is where we need to get into first. So within the address bar, I'm going to get inside of it and we are going to type in the following. We need to get into the directory, background, and shell. So once you hit enter, it's going to take you directly in there. So within the shell node, we need to right click on it. And once we right click on it, we are going to go to new. Within new, we are going to pick key. And the key that we are going to create is called notepad. So I'm going to enter the notepad. Now within notepad, we are going to right click on that new key. We are going to go to new. From here, we are going to click on key because we need to create another key inside notepad. And we are going to name it command. Now, once you do that, we need to locate the path of that notepad. Now, the notepad is actually located within Windows System 32. I'm going to locate the exe file for the notepad. I'm going to hold the shift key and then right click on the notepad application. When I do that, it gives me a new option which allows me to copy as path. So I'm going to pick copy as path. We're going to go back inside the registry editor. And within the command key, we are going to double click on default and paste that path in there. And then click OK. And we're done. Now within the desktop, you're able to right click and you're going to see notepad. And then when you click on notepad, it's going to launch up the notepad. Now the next Windows 10 hack that I like to use is display seconds on the taskbar. As you can see by default, it only gives you hours and minutes, but sometimes I like to see the seconds. So again, within the registry editor, we are going to pick the HKEY current user. Within the address bar, I'm going to click inside of it. And we need to get into software, Microsoft, Windows, current version, Explorer, and Advanced. That is the location that we need to get into. We're going to hit enter. Once you hit enter, it's going to take you directly to that path. How easy is that, right? We're going to right click on Advanced. And within Advanced, we are going to go to New. And within New, we are going to click on DWORD 32-bit value. Now the value name that we are going to pick is the following. Show seconds in system clock. And it has to be exactly the way that you guys see it with the cap letters and everything. So once you rename that DWORD 32, we're going to double click on it. And the value that we are going to set would be 1 and hit OK. And we need to restart your machine or just basically log off, log back on, and you're going to see that, you know, your time clock now has seconds. Now, the next hack that I like to do is remove 3D objects from the PC. So if you open up your Windows Explorer, you're going to see 3D objects. It's a folder that no one uses. Now, to remove 3D objects, it's pretty simple. We are going to select our HKEY local machine. Let's go inside the editor's address bar, and we need to type in the following. We need to go inside software, Microsoft, Windows, current version, Explorer, my computer, namespace. And hit enter. It's going to take you directly there. Now there's a bunch of keys within namespace and you just basically need to locate the one that you need to delete. You're actually deleting it to remove it. So the one that we need to find is this one. The last four characters that you're looking for would be 513A. That is the one that is assigned to the 3D objects folder. So we're going to select it, right click on it, pick delete. It's going to give you a nice little warning. You know, we want to delete it. So click on yes and you're done. You don't need to restart or log off. So go back inside your Windows Explorer and 3D objects is removed. Now, the next one on my list would be disable lock screens. And what is disable lock screens? So you get this, which means you have to, you know, use your mouse or use the directional keys or press the space bar or anything for this guy to go up. And then you're able to log in. And once you log in, it takes you in there. We want to disable that. Now, to disable that within your registry editor, we need to go inside the HKEY local machine. Again, go inside your address bar, and we need to type in the following. We're going to go inside Software, Policy, Microsoft, and then Windows, and hit Enter. It's going to take you directly in there. Now, within the Windows key, we are going to right-click on it, and we are going to go to New, and we are going to pick Key. You're going to rename your new key to the following. It would be Personalization. And within that Personalization key, we're going to right-click on it, go to New, and we are going to pick DWORD32. Now, your DWORD32, we need to rename it, and we're going to rename it the following. No Lock Screen, with a capital N, capital L, and a capital S. We're going to double-click on it, and we're going to make sure that we set the value to 1. Hit OK. Once you're done, you can restart the machine or just log off. But once you log off or you sign out, you're going to see that it's going to directly take you to here. You won't have that lock screen anymore. Now, the next one in my list is all about disabling Bing. If you click on your start menu and you type in, let's say, cats, it's automatically going to go outside and search for cats. You don't want that. You're looking for an image within your machine for cats, right? So to disable Bing within the start menu is pretty simple. Again, we are going to go inside the registry editor. We need to go inside HKEY current user, go inside the address bar, and we need to type in the following. We need to go inside Software, Microsoft, Windows, current version, and search, and hit Enter. Once you do that, it takes you directly there. And on the search key node, we need to right click on it. We're going to pick New. We're going to pick a DWORD 32 bit. And we need to rename it. Change the name to the following as Bing Search Enabled with a capital B, S, and an E. Double click on it and make sure the value is set to 0. Click OK. If you go back to start and you start searching for something, let's say cats, it's not going to go to Bing and search for it. Now, the next one in my list is all about disabling Cortana within Windows 10. Now, again, within the registry editor, we need to go inside your HKEY local machine. And within the address bar, we need to type in the following. We need to get inside Software, Policies, Microsoft, and Windows, and hit Enter. It's going to take you directly there. And within the Windows key node, we need to right-click on it. We are going to go to New, and we are going to create a new key. Now, the new key, we are going to rename it to Windows Search, right? Windows space Search, okay? Now, within your new key, we are going to right-click on it. We're going to go to New, and we are going to pick a DWORD 32-bit value. And that new value, we're going to rename it to the following. Allow Cortana with a capital A and a capital C. We're going to double-click on that key and make sure the value is set to 0. Once you're done, we're going to click OK, restart your machine, and then Cortana should be disabled. And that's it, guys. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed this video. My top 6 registry hacks that I like to use within Windows 10. If you have any, make sure to leave them at the comment section. Also, do not forget about hitting that like button. And also, do not forget about punching, elbow, and smashing that subscribe button to get the latest and greatest from this guy. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.